Hello everyone and welcome to the RV Inspection and Care Channel. I'm Dwayne and I'm a certified RV inspector. And today we're going to be talking about the battle of the towables. That's right, travel trailers versus fifth wheels. And you know, this is a big decision for a lot of newer RVers. They realize that they don't want a motorhome. They want a towable RV. But which way do you go? Travel trailers or fifth wheels? And first of all, let's identify, what are travel trailers? What are fifth wheels? Well, the most identifying characteristic for both is the way they hitch to the tow vehicle. A fifth wheel has a hitch that goes into the middle of the bed of the tow vehicle, right over the rear axle. The travel trailer instead hooks up to the rear of the vehicle. In fact, it's often called a bumper pull. So that's usually the way that you can tell the difference between them. Now, the fifth wheel also usually sits up higher. It's got a much higher profile, but the hitch is the real giveaway. Now, with all of that discussed, as with so many other things that we talk about in RVing, let me emphasize this. There is no one choice that is best for everybody. Not at all. It really depends on a number of factors as to which RV is best for you and your particular situation. But we'll try to cover those factors as we go along. So let's go ahead. Let's get started. And we'll get started with the pros of travel trailers. And the number one pro of travel trailers is versatility. What I mean by that is they come in all kinds of sizes, all the way from 12 feet all the way up to well over 30 feet. So if you want to go RVing, there is a travel trailer that will fit what you're trying to do. And that's really good, especially for newer RVers, to have that flexibility of choice to consider. Now, that leads us to our second pro for travel trailers, and that is usually they can be much less expensive. In fact, if what you're finding is too much for your budget, just go down in size, and eventually you're probably going to find a travel trailer that will fit your budget. And this works very well for, you know, newer RVers that want to get out on the road and they don't have a lot of funds. They have a lot more choices to match their budget. Now, the third pro is that you may not even need a truck for a travel trailer. In fact, many of the smaller ones can be pulled with SUVs or a minivan. And to give you a good idea of that, before we bought our Newmar Class A, why, we had for a few years a little 16-foot travel trailer, and we pulled it with our Toyota Sienna van. And we pulled it all over Florida, and it worked just fine. It was a great combination. So if you don't have the truck to pull an RV, but you want to go RVing, well, there's usually a travel trailer that will fit what you have very often. In fact, also, many travel trailers, even when you get into the bigger ones, can still be pulled by a half-ton pickup. You don't have to get into the big diesels and all of that. In many cases, travel trailers, if you have to get a truck, you can get a less expensive truck by getting the half-ton gas model rather than getting into the diesels. Now, the fourth pro is that smaller travel trailers can fit into more camping spots. It's just the way it is, you know. And the truth is that a lot of campgrounds don't have facilities or much facility for big rigs. So if you like to have a wide choice of camping sites, then travel trailers is the way to go, because you can get a smaller unit that'll fit into more campsites. This is very good for national parks and state parks and things along that line too. All right, the fifth pro is that it is super easy to get smaller travel trailers in and out of boondocking areas. If you want to go boondocking, you know, you just decided, campgrounds, that's not for me. I want to head out there in the middle of nature. I want to really be out there off the grid. Well, a smaller travel trailer is really the way to go, because it's much easier to get them in and out of tough areas, tough terrain, rough terrain, than it is for a larger RV and even fifth wheels. Now, the sixth pro is that it also allows for more storage in the bed of a pickup truck, if that's your tow vehicle. If you have a travel trailer, once again, it's hitching up to the rear of the tow vehicle. So if it's a truck, you have the whole bed available to you for storage space. Many put tonneau covers over it to protect whatever they have in the bed, or you could even choose a bed cap over the bed of the truck, and then you have a ton of storage space in the back of your pickup truck because it's a travel trailer and not a fifth wheel. The seventh pro is it's easier to get on and off of highways, in and out of gas stations, restaurants, shopping areas. If you have a travel trailer, it doesn't have such a high profile. It's easier to maneuver and it's more nimble. So that's a big pro for travel trailers too. Now, it's not all sunshine though with travel trailers. There are cons. Let's talk about that. Number one is they're a little less roomy in their feel inside the RV, and that's often because they don't have as many slides in travel trailers as you will see in fifth wheels and so on. So inside a travel trailer, you're going to have to get used to the walls feeling a little bit closer than you would inside a fifth wheel. The second con is they usually have fewer and smaller appliances. You know, things like the refrigerator is not quite as large in travel trailers as it is in fifth wheels. A lot of the other kind of amenities are smaller. Kitchens tend to be smaller, less counter space, you know, things along that line. So that's another con. Closely related to that is our third con. There's less amenities and luxuries. Yes, why? Well, because weight is a pretty big issue with travel trailers. So to keep the weight down, they don't put in nearly as much gingerbread, you know, the extra things in travel trailers that you will find in larger fifth wheels and so on. Now, the fourth con is that bumper pull RVs can be more difficult to tow. Does that mean they're always more difficult to tow? No, not really, because if you have the right weight distribution hitch, if you have a sway bar installed, if you have the RV balanced as far as the weight distribution, then you know what? Many travel trailers are pretty easy to tow. But when you're comparing as a general rule between fifth wheels and travel trailers, what's the best to pull? Well, the fifth wheel is probably going to win almost every time because of that ability to have the center of gravity right over the rear axle rather than at the back of the tow vehicle. Now, as a travel trailer gets longer, it gets even more pronounced, the difference between travel trailers and fifth wheels and their ease to tow. So that's something to keep in mind. The number five con is that there's less storage in the RV itself than in a fifth wheel. Travel trailers do have storage, but they tend to be kind of small areas, you know, not very large and not very tall and things like that. So, and even inside, there's less storage usually in a travel trailer than in a fifth wheel. Now, this number six con, the build quality. And, you know, some might argue a little bit about this, but I've noticed myself that the build quality is different between travel trailers and fifth wheels, generally speaking. Now, having said that, let me qualify that because there are some travel trailers like Airstreams that are very well built, or smaller ones like Oliver's, very well built. But when we're talking about most travel trailers that you're going to see on an RV dealer's lot, there is a difference in the build quality between the travel trailer, the average travel trailer, and the average fifth wheel. So it's a consideration. So who are travel trailers best for? Well, generally speaking, if you're a weekender, you know, an RVer that goes out on weekends, vacations in RVs and things like that, then a travel trailer may be a very good thing for you. It'll keep the cost down, keep the budget down, it'll allow you more places to go and camp and so on. So very good for weekenders. It's also good for full-timers or part-timers who are under a tight budget, because you can really keep your cost down if you do that with a smaller RV like a travel trailer. It also is good for those who have access to campgrounds where the campgrounds don't really support, you know, large rigs very, very well. So if you're constantly going to those kind of campgrounds, well, then a travel trailer may be a good solution for you to fit in those campsites. It's also good for extreme boondockers. You know, if you're one of those folks that just wants to go way off grid, well, a travel trailer is probably your best bet. And a smaller one with maybe a solar array, that kind of thing, you're going to do great out off grid, way out with a travel trailer. Now, let's get to the fifth wheel pros. And number one, I mean, the number one pro of fifth wheels is the living space. Oh my goodness. You know, you walk in the door into that living room kitchen area, and almost always it feels like an apartment. It doesn't have that camper feel. It feels like you're in an apartment. You know, in some cases you'll have an island kitchen and all of that. The slides, and there's more slides very often than travel trailers. The slides often tend to be deeper, so you really get that wide, spacious feel. That's the number one pro. Also, it tends to have more amenities. You're going to find that with travel trailers, you're going to see a lot more amenities and luxuries. So if you are an RVer that is a glamper, and you know, own up to it, there's nothing wrong with that, and you like to glamp, well then a fifth wheel is probably going to be a better choice for you than the travel trailer, because they usually come with a lot of really nice appointments. In fact, many fifth wheels rival the best Class A motorhomes, so it is a good thing. Now, the number three pro for fifth wheels is that they're easier to tow. Once again, we get back to that hitch. If the hitch is over the rear axle, that's where the center of gravity is, well, then it just makes an easier tow. It's just a fact of life. So as the length increases in the RV, you know, the fifth wheel gets longer and the travel trailer gets longer, usually the difference between the two gets more stark. It's easier and easier to tow a longer RV if it's a fifth wheel. The number four pro for fifth wheels is there's more storage space in the RV. You know, there's usually in almost every fifth wheel, you're going to find a huge storage compartment right up front. And it's not only, you know, can store a lot, it can store taller things, bigger things. Travel trailers, generally the storage areas in them tend to be more restricted in size. In a fifth wheel, you can put bigger things in the space that you have. Also inside, there tends to be more storage space inside a fifth wheel than a travel trailer. Now, the number five pro is that fifth wheels often will come with a built-in generator. Now, not always, but that's kind of nice. I don't know of almost any travel trailer that comes with a built-in generator, but if you buy a fifth wheel, very often you may find that a generator comes that's already installed and built in, and it's enough to run the entire RV. Well, that's a great thing to have. So if that's something that's important to you, then a fifth wheel would be a good choice on that line. The sixth pro, higher build quality. Once again, I have to emphasize that there is a difference. And the build quality tends to go up as the cost of the RV does. That's why you're going to find some fifth wheels can cost between $100,000 and $200,000, whereas travel trailers don't really usually get into that $100,000 range, you know, unless they're Airstreams. But there is a difference in build quality. Number seven, easier backing capabilities for fifth wheels. Did we get back to that hitch? Because it's over that rear axle, it makes a shorter turning radius. So you can usually back a fifth wheel in to a campsite a lot easier than a travel trailer. You can do it quicker and with less effort. So that's a consideration. Now, the cons of fifth wheels. Well, number one con is they're going to cost you more. It is, as a general rule, again, there are travel trailers that will cost more than some fifth wheels. But if you have the comparable size RV in both, generally speaking, most of the time, the fifth wheel is going to cost you more. So if you have a budget, if you've got to watch the pennies a little bit, well, then, you know, a fifth wheel could be difficult for you to bite off in buying that. So it's a consideration. Number two, there are less sizes to choose from with fifth wheels. You know, remember we talked about how travel trailers, it goes all the way from 12 feet to well over 30. Well, with fifth wheels, it's much more limited. Generally speaking, you're going to see most fifth wheels run between 30 and 40 feet, some as much as 45, but generally mostly between 30 and 40. So they're larger. They don't tend to get down into the smaller sizes and that kind of thing. So it is a consideration. You don't have as much versatility to choose from in the size of the RV. Number three, RVs are, or fifth wheels are going to be heavier. When we're talking about added weight, you know, from more amenities and higher quality build and things along that line, well, you're going to talk about a heavier RV. So what does that mean? Well, it means that you're going to have a bigger tow vehicle with a fifth wheel in many cases. You know, you can use half-ton pickup trucks with some fifth wheels, but they tend to be the very smallest of the fifth wheels. Generally speaking, when you get into fifth wheel territory, you're now moving into diesel trucks. Three-quarter ton to one-ton trucks and dualies. And in some cases, if you have the really heavy and big fifth wheels, I know a lot of people that don't want to tow them with anything less than like a medium duty truck. So we're talking about a much more expensive tow vehicle for bigger fifth wheel RVs. So that's a consideration. Not only does the RV cost you more, but very often the tow vehicle will cost you more too. The number four con for RVs or fifth wheels is they're harder to fit in small campsites. You know, not only the fact that they're longer, but very often, you know, they have that tall profile. And you better watch for tree branches with a fifth wheel. It's just it's the truth. Some of these campgrounds don't prune their tree branches like they should, and you'll find some serious damage being done by backing fifth wheels into smaller campsites. So that's a consideration. The number five con, loss of bed space in a truck for the fifth wheel. Remember how we mentioned the travel trailer is a bumper pull, so it leaves your whole bed open for whatever you want to put in it. Just the opposite for a fifth wheel. You've got to put that big hitch right in the middle of the bed. And there's not a lot of stuff that you can put in around it. I mean, there are certain things you can, but it's not nearly as flexible as the truck bed being used with a travel trailer. So that is something to think about, because you're going to lose some of that storage space. If you really need a lot of storage space, the truck bed could be a great place to get it, but with a fifth wheel, it's going to be much more difficult. Now, you can take the hitch in and out, but that's a project, so you've got to consider that. Now, the sixth con for fifth wheel RVs is they often will have worse fuel economy too, because of their size. Again, you know, we get back to size, weight, profile, all those things. They contribute to a more difficult pull and therefore more fuel economy. When I say difficult pull, it means that the engine, there has to be a bigger engine or there has to be more fuel use to get that down the highway. And so that is a consideration. It's not a huge one. I wouldn't say that there's just a tremendous difference between fifth wheels and travel trailers, but it is something to consider. Now, having considered the pros and the cons of fifth wheels, who's best for getting a fifth wheel? Well, it's best for part-time RVers or full-time RVers who, they have a little bit more money to spend. You know, they're not as tight on the nickels and quarters and things like that. Well, if you have a little bit more money than a fifth wheel, you're going to enjoy the more space when you're out on the road, really living in it as opposed to a travel trailer. Also, people who want more of an apartment feel and not a camper feel. You know, if you're a glamper, then own up to it and say, you know what, I need a fifth wheel. Because a travel trailer, you're probably just not going to be super comfortable with. So these are the kind of folks that are usually best to go with a fifth wheel. All right, now, having discussed all of these things that we've talked about, emphasize again, review your needs. What's your budget? What kind of camping do you plan on doing? You know, where are you going to go with your RV? These kinds of things. What vehicle do you have now? What kind of changes is it going to require you to make to get into RVing? If you got to change your, you got to get a tow vehicle and the RV, that's a lot. Maybe you already have a vehicle that would work with a travel trailer. So these are all considerations that you have to make as to what's best for you and your situation. If you consider all the pros and cons and you think about it clearly and really take your time, then in most cases, you're going to make a really good decision between the two. Well, I hope you enjoyed that information. If you did, would you do me a favor and like the video? Because YouTube likes it when you like the video. Also, I'd love to have you comment below. We really need to hear from you. You know, these are subjects that a lot of people have strong opinions about, and it's okay if you share your opinions. But we really like to hear objective opinions. And, you know, any contribution you can make toward this discussion of fifth wheel versus travel trailers would be really appreciated. Please visit our website too at rvinspectionandcare.com. There's a lot of information there that you won't even find on YouTube. Finally, I would love to have you as part of our online family. To do that, all you have to do is hit that subscribe button. That way you won't miss any of the videos that I keep putting out. Now they're coming out on a twice weekly basis. Well, that's it for now. Have safe and happy travels, my friends. Until next time.